bringing you action and welcoming you to the Metro Manila Arena here in the Philippines. 10 rounds slated in the books tonight. Here's the first. Pernell Whitaker isn't giving us anything to talk about right here, Teddy. He's not moving, he's not boxing, he's not fighting.
Well, 75% of this business is mental, and you would love to know mentally what's going on in his mind right now.
Not much. Seconds to go here in this round. Missed that uppercut. Targeting that overhand left.
Do that again.
Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot. Final 10 seconds. End of the round. Joe Tessitore and Teddy Atlas with you ringside. He just didn't throw enough, Teddy. I mean, you got to go out there and put something forth if you want to win the round.
Hey, sometimes it's complicated. Sometimes it's pretty simple. You don't throw punches, you don't win fights.
Nice work. Doing well.
Here we go. Round two is underway. Oh, what an exchange! Oh, he just misses with that headshot. Putting his punches together, good combination by Pernell Whitaker. Listen, everybody likes to see a great knockout shot to the chin, but truth be told, at this stage of a fight, the foundation for winning comes by going downstairs.
It's just like the old timers would say, so you kill the body, the head will follow.
Able to land the hook to the head.
Oh! Hey, you gotta see that coming.
Oh, his opponent got away from that uppercut. Whitaker's got to deal with a cut around his eye. Now, it looks like it's below his eye, so we'll see what kind of effect it has. He digs in with an uppercut after blocking that shot away. Whitaker's sitting back right now, Teddy, and looking for that counterpunch opportunity, isn't he?
Yeah, that's exactly what he's doing. He's waiting, you know, he sees that his opponent is in his armory, so to speak. You know, he's in his castle. He's getting him to come out of his castle. He wants him to come out of his castle, so now he can attack.
Unable to make an impact there by Pernell Whitaker. And clicks of the talk. He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. 3 minutes gone by in this round.
You need to move your head more, side to side, okay? I want to see that head.
Listen to me. I need you to keep busy, all right? I need more than one punch now. This fight is even, so I need to see more than one punch out there.
And round number three is underway. Halfway through this round. Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head. He missed with that headshot. He fires back. He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores. A headshot blocked. He takes a shot and then commits to giving one right back. We count down the final moments of this round. And that's the end of round three.
You're losing this fight. We need you to take some chances now. You have to take a chance with this guy, right? You got that? You have to.
Whitaker's ahead on Teddy's scorecard as we take a peek at those scores for the first time here today. Round number four just underway. After three rounds, he finds himself up just a round, but nothing really to pull away early on.
Uppercut!
Well, I don't know if he's hip to the idea of becoming a counterpuncher, but I get the sense you'd agree with it.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, he's got the perfect platform, the perfect form for it. The guy's walking in right now, not moving his head much. He can time him. He can counter him.
Pace yourself.
Scores up top with a left. Halfway through round number four. Pernell Whitaker's on the bad end of a very impressive hook up top. He's committed to going to the gut. Whitaker's movement's really helping him out, avoiding that punch.
Keep moving.
Unable to land clean by Pernell Whitaker. Whitaker's doing a brilliant job with his head movement. He's employing top-notch defense right here, and it's frustrating his opponent.
It is frustrating his opponent. His opponent needs to make an adjustment of thinking right now and understand what's there, not what's not there. We know that the head's not there, but what's there? The body. He needs to start going downstairs. That will freeze up some of that head movement.
Fine work with the left hand. He landed well by Pernell Whitaker. Whitaker's almost looking foolish that time he missed so badly. Still plenty of time to work here in round number five. Minute and a half to go. Whitaker's well off the mark that time. That is boxing 101. A nice, crisp combination by Pernell Whitaker. Whitaker's defense is paying off now. Gets rid of that. It was intended for his head. Blocks a shot and then lands an uppercut of his own. Couldn't hit the elusive target with that straight right. Whitaker's trainer right now is telling him, hey, we can pull this fight out. You may be trailing. There's not much left, but it's still there. You can still go out there and get this win. There's the headshot, but he parries it away.
Punch! Punch!
Whitaker's putting on a show here. Defensively putting on a show.
And it's helping his offense because, you know, he's creating holes. He's creating opportunities. Holes that he's filling as he makes his opponent miss.
Halfway through round six. How about that exchange? You can see he's trying to score up top, but off the mark there.
Still not moving enough. Move!
One, gives one. The right hand scores well. Took a shot. Now he gives a left.
Uppercut.
Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. That's what Sweet Pea does best. Good counterpunch. Good return fire that time. Back to action here at the start of this round, which is just part of what has been a very evenly fought fight. One of those fights that's going to be very hard to score.
Let's see some more hand movement.
He just missed that shot up top. Whitaker's leaving himself wide open there. You just can't do that.
Well, you can do it, but you're going to get paid. You're going to eat some leather. You're going to get punched in the mouth. That's going to happen.
Nice work blocking that, and then an uppercut of his own.
Keep moving. Keep moving.
Little head knocking with that right hand. Well-placed counterpunch by Pernell Whitaker. At the halfway point of round seven. That was not well targeted by Pernell Whitaker. Thank you. Vernell Whitaker showing you a little defensive skill there. Able to move away from that punch. That's a fierce left hand that landed by Vernell Whitaker. Tucks those elbows in, blocks the body shot. He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. And that's the end of round 7.
Let's go. What are you waiting for? You want this fight? Then let's get moving out here. This guy's going to win this fight. If you don't take control, buddy, you need to take control.
Start of round number 8. Whitaker's in control, according to Teddy's scorecard. The busier guy, really, when you look at the totality of this fight, that's the way to describe it. He's been the busier guy.
Yeah, he's been working when the other guy's not working.
Relax.
And in close rounds, that's enough to get him, at least on my card.
Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. Good block by Vernell Whitaker. Really frustrating his opponent now. Whitaker's so defensively sound, it doesn't make for an easy target.
No, it doesn't. And it makes for a very frustrating night for his opponent. I see his opponent now, if you notice, he's getting a little tentative. He's afraid to let the punches go because when he misses, he's worried he's going to leave an opening.
Seconds to go, halfway through round 8. Commits to the straight right. Able to land the headshot.
Pace yourself.
Last 10 seconds of the 8th round. A little something for his opponent after getting tagged. And that's the end of round 8. Whitaker's margin for error is hardly anything at all now. It's later in the fight, and time again, he's allowing his opponent to land these headshots.
Yeah, you got to remind them, you're not getting paid any bonus, no extra money for taking punches. You might get paid a little extra if you start delivering some, though.
Keep moving. That's what I want to see.
Good block there by Vernell Whitaker. Whitaker's showing us that he's aggressive, but this is not a good kind of aggression. You can be countered this way.
Yeah, it's a reckless aggression. You know, he's just walking in there, you know, with these big wide punches. Something's going to come in between.
Not precise at all by Vernell Whitaker. To the head he goes with a left hand. 90 seconds into the 9th round. Not able to land the uppercut.
Jab, jab.
If there was a baseball umpire around, he'd call that a strikeout by Vernell Whitaker. Last 10 seconds of the 9th round. Not what he was looking for. That's a miss right there by Vernell Whitaker. And the bell rings, signifying the end of the round. Whitaker's plan that his corner put forth throughout all training camp was exactly what we're seeing here. Fighting from the outside, scoring at will. His opponent, they haven't solved it once.
And I'm shocked because, you know what? There's tape on this guy. There's video out there. We knew that he was going to fight this kind of fight. How did they not know, and how did they not prepare for it?
Teddy, I'm starting to wonder, what is the answer for this guy? Can he do anything else than this? Yeah, he throws punches, but he has no accuracy. Can this change in mid-fight?
Well, it has to if he wants to win this fight. And how does it change? Well, you know, the problem is these things have to be put in place in the gym. I don't know if you could do it right now, but if you could, you tell him in the corner, hey, tighten up a little bit, you know, shorten up these darn punches.
Takes one to give one. He comes back with a right hand. He got caught right there. Everything was going fine, and then he got caught.
Well, that's the problem. It was going too fine. He got a false sense of security. The other guy wasn't thrown back. He took for granted, and bang, you can't take for granted in this ring.
Off target with that hook. Last dance, last chance. Last minute of the last round. Comes right back with a shot of his own. Off to the side, a little swing and a miss going upstairs. Good block by Pernell Whitaker. And they will bring it home in the last 10 seconds of this final round. Needs to improve that accuracy, missed with the headshot. That was a highly competitive back-and-forth bout. Now, let's hear which way it went. Sweet pea, Pernell Whitaker is your winner by majority decision tonight.
You know, I know there's going to be an argument with me in the barbershop tomorrow because my barber's going to be saying, what were they watching? I agree with him. I don't know what the judges were watching.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. That does it ringside. We'll see you next time at the fights.